Hello everyone and welcome to this class. In this class we are going to be creating the necessary pages for our blog. So firstly we are going to create the about us page. We'll go to pages and we are going to create one. Click on new page and choose about us. As usual, we are just going to paste the lorem ipsum. The about us is where you tell your audience what your blog is about, what you do, and things like that. So you are going to compose that by yourself. So I'll just leave it like that. Normally pages, we don't allow comments in pages. It's not conventional. So there's nothing for you to comment on about your blog. So there's no need for comments. We are going to choose don't allow. So that should be all. And publish. The next page we are going to create is the privacy policy page. Privacy policy lets your readers know what you do with their data, whatever information you get from them. Probably think we from the beginning of the course, at the beginning, the first video, I explained that Google said all you need privacy policy to tell them what to use those cookies for, the data you get from the cookies. There's a website that you can generate free privacy policy. And this is the website. I'm going to include it in the materials that will be sent to the group, the address of the website. So start creating your privacy policy. And I'm an individual. I work in Nigeria. Next step, the website URL. Simply come here, copy your URL and paste it here. What is your website name? Blockchain. Next step. What kind of personal information you collect from users? Collect their email. You send email to your users? Yes, we do. How can users unsubscribe? By clicking on subscribe link. Yes. Do you ask for location information? No, we don't ask for that. You use tracking and then, yes, we use Google Analytics. Yes. Next step. How can users contact you by email? You put the email, the official email that is in your blog. Yeah. Next step. So our privacy policy has been created. We want to create a free privacy policy. Next step. Because you are not paying. So the next thing for you to do is to input your email and they will send it to you to your email. And that's it. Our privacy policy is being generated. So the privacy policy has been sent to the email. Firstly, also it has been generated here. So once I click on it, it has been copied to the clickboard. It has been copied. I'll come here and I'll name the page privacy policy. If you don't have a privacy policy, Google will not grant you AdSense. It will not grant you AdSense. The text is in HTML. So here we will not use the compose mode, we use the HTML mode. Come here and Ctrl V, then under options here, same thing, don't allow, we won't allow comments, and publish. That's it, we have our privacy policy generated. Then next we are going to create our contact us page. For contact page, how do we create a contact page? Before coming to create a contact page, let's contact us. Okay, publish. The contact page is going to add form to the page. So before we do that, we have to add the contact widget to our, even though that is not yet time for us to do that, but let's quickly run through that. We are not talking about widgets in videos to come, we'll talk about widgets proper, but for now we're just going to add the contact widget and we'll choose and contact form. So I'm going to add the contact form and it's going to be added. Good. Save it. And now after adding our blogger widget, the next thing we are going to do is to hide it. We need to hide the contact form. Now we'll go to settings. I'm going to Teams and customize. Go to Advanced and custom CSS. Add CSS. Now there's a code we are going to add here. I already have it here. I will send it to the group. Just paste this code. Ctrl C and Ctrl V and apply to blog. The contact form will be hidden. Good. So let's go back. The next thing for us to do is to add the contact form to our contact page. Add the contact form to our contact page. We'll go back to our pages, contact us, edit. There's a code we are going to paste there. This code, I'm going to share it with the group or in the group also. So copy everything from here down. Ctrl C. We are going to paste it on the group. Ensure that you are in HTML section of the composer. Then the next thing we will need after pasting this, we will need to change the blogger ID. This, you have to change this number.